Americans produce a lot of trash. In 2010, the EPA says Americans threw away about 250 million tons of it. All that decomposing waste produces the toxic gas known as methane. In fact, landfills are the third largest source of methane emissions in the country.
Decomposing trash doesn't just disappear, it transforms. Like all forms of matter, it goes into a different state. One of those states is gas, methane gas, carbon dioxide is another.
Here's why environmental advocate Fred Tutman says you should care. If a landfill or dump site isn't properly built or maintained, methane can escape and invade basements or enclosed spaces of nearby homes and buildings.
It can cause problems that no one ever considered or even dreamed of when this stuff was originally put in the ground.
Perhaps the biggest problem?
That's enough to say that methane can make things go boom.
If it had accumulated in a space where there was an ignition source, and the homes behind us, there's pilot lights for your water heater, for your heater itself. So those are sources of ignition. A hot radiator, you pull your car in your garage, those types of hazards that in the house would be your typical flame that could ignite those things.
Mick Butler is the chief of the Environmental Division at Fort Meade, Maryland. He and other leaders at this Army post know all too well what it's like to face methane as an enemy. As a safety precaution, they evacuated 20 homes at Fort Meade. Due to the ongoing battle with methane and explosion concerns, these homes have sat empty for 8 years.
It was something that we never thought that we would ever have to deal with, but I had the full confidence in the team here at Fort Meade and our housing partner. We did the right thing. We made the right decision.
Underneath this Fort Meade field, officials discovered a World War II-era dump site. While its leftover artifacts painted a picture of the mid-1940s, it also contained a lot of methane-generating trash.
The operational practice at that time was simply, for landfilling, was to dig a hole and put your waste in the hole. That was the standard of practice at the time.
To comply with the EPA, today's landfills must include a liner to prevent methane and other hazardous materials from leaking into the soil, groundwater, pipes, and buildings. During the 40s, that wasn't the case. So as you can imagine, methane levels spiked around the field.
My feelings were really quite profound. My job is to ensure the safety and protection of the community here. And I really felt it personally that it was important to do something permanent as quickly as possible.
That included evacuating families because of the potential for explosions. And since methane can make people sick, the trash needed to go too, around 27,000 tons or 1,000 truckloads. Workers then capped off the historic landfill and converted it to green space. The total cost, $2.5 million. Leaders at Fort Meade believe it's worth it.
You could not get any more high on a list of concerns than a site adjacent to a family housing area and an elementary school. So as a father, as a person, you know, the safety of those occupants was prime on your list, and it couldn't have gotten any worse for us to have this location here in that close proximity.
So what are some solutions to prevent methane from landfills from harming people and the environment? At the landfill behind me, the methane that's generated from decaying trash is reclaimed or harnessed and then used to heat another area facility.
Some sites now are actually harvesting the gas because there's an opportunity to use this flammable, combustible gas to generate energy, power, run automobiles, for power generation, basically.
Generally, it's either electricity of some type, putting it back on the grid, or using it to run buildings that are located close by.
Regardless if it's eventually harnessed and reused, methane needs to be properly contained and controlled. As they continue to monitor methane levels around this grassy field, environmental leaders at Fort Meade hope to eventually put people back in these homes. They see this project as a true success story, but at the same time, advise you to educate yourself. Visit state and local websites to find out if a landfill or dump site near your home is truly secure. Mark Martin, CBN News, Maryland.